Well, what inflation means is that the value of the dollar is going down. So a simple example here I want to give you is I'm going to the supermarket to buy toothpaste, and this is my favorite, Crest. Okay, and this is 5 fluid ounces of Crest. Okay, and maybe that cost me $3. Well, inflation means either I need to buy, spend more of them to buy this thing, or alternatively, I can use my $3, but I get less. And so this is like a 1 ounce of Crest. Okay, so now that costs $3. One of the problems is that COVID's really disrupted what we call the supply chain of production. So manufacturers, say, in the United States are getting parts or chips or other kinds of materials from other places in the world, have to be shipped here by boat. And because of COVID, the process of producing those things somewhere else got disrupted, or even the transportation, they got to load it up into a ship and then deliver it to port here and unload it and ship it by truck. And that whole process, all the links in that chain have been disrupted, which means that certain things have been harder to get. And that means the price of those things has gone up. With restaurants, people sick with COVID or scared about getting COVID, they don't want to work in the restaurant for a while. The restaurant manager's, having trouble meeting all the customers' demands. He might cut back his hours, but he might also need to raise his wages of his workers. And then he's got to pass that through into the prices of the products he charges. Because of COVID, the prices of all those things are rising. Generally speaking, no one really likes inflation. Almost no one likes it. One problem is that if you're a worker, a lot of times your salary, your wage rate only gets adjusted once a year, maybe twice a year, depending on where you work. So the cost of living is increasing over the course of the year. And when the price of all those things are going up and your salary or your monthly income isn't changing, and for a family that's just barely making ends meet, that can be really tough. These problems I mentioned with the supply chains, they haven't gone away yet. Part of the reason is because China's still really struggling with COVID in China and trying to make sure that it doesn't spread there. The port facilities are still clogged. So some of those problems aren't going to be resolved anytime soon. And meanwhile, a lot of businesses are trying to help their workers keep up with the cost of living by increasing their pay. But then those businesses need to pass on the extra wage costs into the price that they charge their customers. So we call this a wage price dynamic. And that's getting more and more entrenched into the economy. The Federal Reserve's really got to make some changes to their policies to try to bring inflation back down, make sure that prices stay stable over time. I would say we really need political leaders on both sides of the aisle to be supporting the Federal Reserve, doing whatever it needs to do to make sure that the value of the dollar stays stable over time. And so if you ask me, what can we do? The answer is we really need to make sure the Federal Reserve does its job.